Welcome, everyone, to the Falcon Athletic Network, your number one source for all things Daytona State College athletics. I'm Tom James. We have an amazing show. We go off the pavement tonight with the women's and men's cross-country teams. Let's welcome in first the women's team, joined by head coach Judy Wilson, Sophia Azzolini, and Giovanna Mead. Thank you guys all for taking the time this evening to join us.
Thanks for having us.
Busy schedule, I know, for all of you. Now, Coach, I know you have a very celebrated history in cross country. It started, of course, for you as a runner way back. Tell us about that and your journey from those days to where you are today at Daytona State.
We don't have enough time.
How long you got?
How long do you have? Well, you know, I did the typical run in high school, run in college kind of thing. And then when I got out of college, my coach was like, you know, you should coach. And so I was like, oh, I don't know about that. But I got a job at a local high school, and I liked it. I really liked it. I liked helping them. I liked giving back, you know, and trying to get people to kind of have a little bit of an experience like I had. I had a really good experience. And I loved my coaches. I mean, they were just great people. And so I think that drew me to it. But I went to South Florida, and I coached there for a year. And then I came back to Indiana, and I had a little school called DePauw University. It's a D3 school. And I had the entire program, men's, women's, track, and cross country. 26 years old, had, you know, a guy that was 45 that was my assistant that just, you know, was great and learned a lot. And then went to UConn for 2 years. Went back to my alma mater, Indiana University, for 9 years. Okay. Coached there. Took 10 years off out of coaching. And then in 2017, I met with Will and took this job.
Wow. So 10 years away from cross country.
Yeah. I have a son, and between 5 years old and 15 years old, I got to see him. I got talked into coaching soccer. Don't ask me to do that. but it was a lot of fun. Yeah. And I'm glad I had those years.
Good. Well, I know they're glad that you're back where you are in cross country these days. Listen, already a very successful season so far for you guys. Let's take a look at some video of the ladies. Run through this with us, if you will. No pun intended, of course. But it's been successful. Who are we seeing here, and tell us about this journey so far this season?
Well, this is Sophia Azzolini, who's sitting next to me here in the studio, and she actually came to us from soccer and switched over to cross country. And then you just saw Jenny Enslin and Chris Gray, who come out and help, but they were on the 2018-2019 team, who were, you know, non-traditional students. On the left is Kennedy Arterburn from Winter Springs High School, who was on a two-time state championship team. And we're out doing what's called a fartlek run. It's a Swedish word, and it means to play with speed. It's kind of like what you see soccer people do on the soccer field.
Okay.
So they run, they you know, they'll pick it up, they'll slow down. They'll do that for a certain set of minutes. You can see two girls up ahead is, on the right is Alexis Mills and Jonna Kirk, and then Giovanna was actually ahead of her a little bit. And then this is Shannon Jones. And right now she's our top runner. She is probably about a minute and a half ahead of any of the other girls, so she kind of has a little bit of a different structure in terms of workouts.
Okay.
And these are, of course, the number of any one of 20 pairs of shoes that the girls wear.
You have a wardrobe.
This, you know, running in Florida, running cross country in Florida, Tom, it's just hot. It's you know, it's brutal some mornings. And the heat and humidity,
yeah,
it can be likened to running at altitude. You know, when you go run at altitude, you get a really good training effect. And a lot of times that's what we can get down here too.
Different kind of a challenge.
Yeah. Much different, yes. Very difficult.
You guys are wearing out the pavement out there, it looks like. I know ladies just ran in the FCSAA Region 8 Championships. Very successful trip to Tallahassee for you guys. Tell us a little bit about how that went.
Well, we finished second, yeah. And the great thing about this year is we did that with three girls who've never run cross country.
Wow.
Giovanna's ran a semester of track in high school, one semester. So Sophia was a soccer player, and Jonna was a gymnast.
Yeah.
And so we started the season, And I was like, oh my gosh, I hope that all of these girls make it through the season and they're healthy when we go to FSU for November 12th. Uh-huh. And thank goodness we've kept them healthy. They've improved so much. It's been great to watch. It's been great.
Let's hear from you guys and tell us about that FCSAA Region 8 championship that you just ran. Successful Sophia, tell us about how that experience was for you.
Well, this was probably one of the coolest meets for me because I can finally see some of my progress. I've probably gone down by like about 4 to 5 minutes with my PR, and it was just really cool to finally see some improvement in this race. And it was really cool because all of us were running together and working together to get that second place spot.
Now, Sophia, you used to play soccer, as Coach mentioned. That was in high school. Mm-hmm. So how has this whole transition from soccer to cross country been for you?
Yeah, it's been different, but it's been really, really amazing. I've been working really hard, and honestly, it's been a lot harder with the training than soccer was personally. But it's been a great transition. Everyone on the team has been super supportive, even if I'm a little bit towards the back, but it's been really great.
And I was going to ask you a little bit more about the difference in the training. Okay, from soccer to cross country, explain a little bit about that.
Yeah, so for soccer, there is a level of endurance, but it's a lot different than cross country. There's more like short distance sprinting type workouts rather than our 8 mile long runs. But yeah, it's great. And I've been working really hard, and it's been a struggle and sometimes, but it's been great overall.
Well, Giovanna, how about you? I mean, I know you ran track and field in high school as well, so it's been something that's been a great passion of yours. What made you want to continue, you know, doing this into college and here at Daytona State?
Well, honestly, I started track and field like a little bit late. I started my senior year, so I wasn't even set on cross country. I never thought about running it at all, but once I contacted Coach Wilson, she convinced me. And I'm glad she did, because it's a different ball game, but it's running at the end of the day, and I wanted to run.
You're glad she contacted you. I think she is too, by the way.
So. Very much.
it's a little bit more similar, I think, than going from soccer to cross country, going from track and field to cross country. Mm-hmm. But it's pavement to off road, if you will. Mm-hmm. Talk about the differences.
Honestly, well, I can't speak from too much experience, but track, it's quick. I was a 400 runner, so it was going to get done in around a minute, I should say. So the training was more intense, but it finished quicker. But for cross country, we could be out there for an hour, hour and a half. Depends on what kind of workout. Sometimes we have like eight mile long runs. Sometimes we get done in like 45 minutes, but I would say I like cross country. I'm starting to like it a little bit more, but you know, I'm just excited for the track season.
It takes a little getting used to, but you're starting to get into it. How do you build your endurance? I mean, through the season, I would guess that even though maybe you get a little tired as the season goes on in some ways, you also probably get a little stronger. Is that true? What's that like?
Well, incorporating the circuits that our coach gives us along with like the running, I mean, showing up to practice, that's the main thing. Like, I should say, like repetition, that'll get you the most progress. And at the end of the day, you're gonna run your race. But as long as you're showing up to practice and you want it, you're gonna get better. Yeah. So I say all of us really have just, I see the big difference.
Well, the proof is in the results, that's for sure.
And
I mean, Coach, you were the first and only cross-country coach ever here at Daytona State. What's your favorite part of coaching these women?
I think every time they see that, they have this little aha moment, you know, where they just make that step. And it's like Sophia, you know, she, I think her first race was 27 minutes, I think. And I was just like, come on, you're going to get better, you know. And now she's 23, 30, you know, 5, and she's still got another race yet. And you know, to get somebody like Gigi, it's just amazing because, you know, she ran one lap on the track in high school. And I was like, okay, you just ran a 62. What if I said slow down to 90 seconds, right? And she's like, oh, I'd be jogging. And I'm like, yeah, we're just going to do that 12 times around the track. You know, it's just these aha moments. I love those. I think those are great.
I think those are some of the things that make this kind of a job so rewarding for you overall in your history as a coach, whether it be here or elsewhere. What are maybe your most proud moment or some of your proudest moments in your career?
I would say that when I see, when I have people call me 5 or 10 years later and they're running, you know, or that they still keep up with it. You know, they still keep going. We have a young woman from our program who, Hannah Capel, she is at Tampa and she's finishing she's in her master's program, her fifth year. And she started with us and ran, you know, 20, 30, you know, in the 5K. And now she's running 18 minutes. And just to have people call, you know, and say, I'm still running, you know, because it's a lifetime thing. It can be a lifetime thing.
And still setting some of those personal goals.
Yeah,
and passing them and beating them.
Yeah.
Well, how about you ladies? After Daytona State, after your time here is finished and you graduate, what is next for you? First, Sophia.
Well, I'm an elementary education major, so I plan on being an elementary school teacher. So, yeah.
Very good. Mm-hmm. Very good. Will you still run?
Yes.
Okay.
Of course.
All right. It's in your blood.
You
can't get rid of that. Gigi, how about you?
Me, I do want to become like a forensic scientist. I like that type of study. I really want to do something with science or math, so I will pursue my career in that. But I also want to run at a Division I school. So I'm trusting myself and coach to get me there, and hopefully I'll make it up there.
I like it, setting some lofty goals for yourself and still running while you can, and then you have some plans after that. Very exciting.
Thanks.
All right, well, thank you guys. Thank you, ladies, again for joining us. The Lady Falcon Runners have had, as we mentioned, an amazing season so far. Let's take a look out of the past two events. They have placed 7th. Out of 12 teams. Another past event, they placed 7th out of 14, and out of one other past event, a 19th out of 30 teams. So some terrific results, and we appreciate you guys joining us. That's all the time we have for the Lady Falcons. But up next, we have the men's cross-country team. And before we get to that, though, let's switch gears a little bit. Welding, hair, makeup, it's all available to you here at Daytona State. We'll be right back. All right, welcome back to the Falcon Athletic Network. Tom James here, joined again by head coach Judy Wilson. And this time we talk about the Daytona State men, and we welcome in Christian, Rocco, and Mitchell Curtis. Thank you guys for taking the time this evening. I know you're busy, as always. Coach, how do you feel, and I think I know the answer to this question, but how do you feel about the team's performance recently in the regionals?
I you have to feel good. We've won four out of the last five titles.
Yeah.
And, you know, I said, guys, we're just going to do what we need to do. We're just going to go in. We want to try to just win it and leave. And we've got 2 weeks to nationals. We don't need anything, you know, bad happening or anything. We're just going to go and win it and leave. And that's what we did.
And you did win it. Yeah.
Yeah. It was good.
And not only did you win this year's regionals, you have won now how many? Four of the last five?
Four out of the last five. Yeah,
we've been
blessed for sure.
All right. So how do they look? How does this team look right now to you in your eyes and your mind heading into the nationals? Because it's right around the corner.
Well, we're in a good spot. I mean, they've run the course collectively. These guys have run that course so many times, and a lot of them in high school. Even the freshmen have run that course in high school. We've run it twice before now in 8K distance. Lansing is ranked number one in the country, and it's Lansing. It's Lansing, Michigan, and they have to come down here and run, and it's hot and it's humid. Two Arizona teams are ranked ahead of us. Again, they run in dry conditions, and so, you know, we hope we have the home court advantage. We think we have the home court advantage. So
it's amazing how the different regions of this very large country that we live in brings a lot of weather differences and home field advantage,
yes.
I guess. If you will. Coach, we have some video of the men practicing. Walk us through this, if you will, who we're seeing here and what you guys are working on. I know that you're wearing out the pavement there.
Yeah, so this was actually Tuesday before the regional, and I'm in the blue car behind them yelling at them. I can't necessarily keep up anymore. But Christian's in the front in the blue shorts, and Sebastian's to his right, and then Jared Fulchuk, our freshman, is there, and then Mitchell had the GoPro on. And they're doing basically 5 minutes, 4 minutes, 3 minutes, 2 minutes, 1 minute.
Yeah.
At a pretty good pace, but there's some rest in there, some jogging, but not too much, not a lot.
I got to ask you guys, do you guys ever wish to say, Coach, let me get in the car and you run and we'll yell at you for a minute?
Oh, all the time. All the time. Yeah. Especially on those hot days.
Yeah.
My coaches used to do that too, and they'd drive by and say something, and you know, you'd hear somebody on the team make a comment, you know, every now and then. So you got to have a thick skin, but you know, Christian and Sebastian here have really, you know, been they work really well together. Mitchell is this is their trio. You know, to me, this was the trio that came in last year, and really, that's when I thought, oh my gosh, we could win a title, because I knew this meet was coming up at FSU. And then we have Julian Palmalis, Jared is right there, and Javen Garcia, who they've just done really well. So we've got a good group of people. These guys have worked so hard. You can see again, like I said, that's Javen right there. But it's hot, you know, it's humid, and it's tough. It's tough running. They probably did 9-10 miles that morning.
Wow.
So,
Christian, tell us about the South Florida Invitational. I know that was one that you were very successful in. You won it. It was at the Claw, and that's what they call USF's cross-country course. Talk about that experience.
Well, going into the race, Coach was telling me in my mind, I need to stay with these two guys, and I was kind of picking them out in the race, so like as the race progressed and I was in that front pack and they were slowly putting in surges and my teammates were cheering me on and it kind of helped me push through because my coach was like, surge at this point. And with surges, it kind of helps to like speed up in the race because sometimes you kind of fall off pace a little bit. So doing that surge, I was up there and towards like the end of the race, it was kind of like a decision because I remember my teammate Christian Pastrana, he was like before the race, he was like, you could win this one. Like he was like, you could win it.
Yeah.
So like thankfully that was in the cards that day and I used that kick and pushed through.
Tell us what's going on in your head in that time when you're getting close to the finish line, you can see it you have that feeling at that point that you know it's yours. What's that like for you?
Oh, Tom, it was a battle. I would say that because I was moving up there because it's a 5 mile race, and around 4 miles, that's when the pack starts separating. And it was me and like three other guys, and I made a surge again because I was like, I'm falling off. Like mentally, it was kind of hard at that moment, but once I surged a little faster than the other guys, and it actually felt easier, and I kind of just hopped into a rhythm, and I took the lead at mile four. So I like moved in through mile four, and I was leading a good amount, like 10 feet ahead, and then another guy came back up on me. And it's funny you ask about the kick, because on the final like 100 meters or so, the guy was on me, and I was like, I just need to, and I put in the kick. And
turned it on.
Yeah, I turned it on.
Very good.
Yeah.
That's fantastic. Well, you guys are both sophomores. Mitchell, I know that in your first season, you're ranked as one of the top three runners. How is this year going for you?
This year, it's been good, like with the new team and everything. I've really enjoyed this team that we have this year. I feel like we have like a lot of good team chemistry, and we all have like our like goals that we're heading towards in these last 2 weeks of the season. So overall, I just feel like it's just been super fun season and like a super rewarding season.
Talk to me a little bit about training and what it takes to consistently keep putting in faster times, and what do you do? What's the process there, your regimen, if you will, to get faster and faster as time goes on?
Yeah, well, a lot of that just comes with being lucky enough to have a good coach like Coach Wilson, and just having teammates that motivate you every day to get up and grind. Like Christian over here, he's my roommate, and we got three other roommates with us, and like we all encourage each other every day to just get out there and give it our best. Like one of our models this season was every day in every way we're getting better and better, and I feel like we've truly tried to continue doing that every day.
And I know you guys are driven, but there's got to be some times when you're just not feeling it, or you're not feeling it as much as you know you need to. What is it that keeps that motivation up during a long season for you?
Honestly, it's just the end goal vision, knowing what it's for. Yeah. Like, you know you have a vision in mind that your team set out to do, and knowing that you have to do your part so that the next guy is there and they're supported and everyone just doing their part to make sure that they feel like we're doing everything we can to get to the goal that like we have.
Yeah. Coach, what do you do how do you motivate your runners?
I was just sitting here thinking, you know, one time my coach said to me, oh, it's okay, go ahead and sleep in, because you know, Susie at X school, she's probably sleeping in too. You know, and that's just enough to kind of get you out the door. You know, yeah. Just to know that somebody somewhere who wants to beat you is getting up that morning and is going for their run.
So that's a pretty interesting tactic. Or do you have any other tactics, kind of a little reverse psychology tactics you use like that?
I don't know. You might have to ask these guys. But I really like to look at where people are in training and then tell them, hey, this is physiologically, this is what this chart says you can run. Here it is in black and white, you know, and sometimes, I mean, people really see that and they're like, oh, okay, you know, they can go for it. So.
Very good.
But yeah.
All right, you guys, Christian, first to you, how did you start becoming a runner? I mean, I hear all kinds of different answers on this question, but what was it for you?
Kind of similar to Giovanna, how she started running. I started off as like a sprinter in middle school. So I started way back in middle school. And I always liked running in a way. Like in gym, I liked running and racing. I liked the idea of racing and winning. So in middle school, going throughout high school, I was a sprinter. And then like sophomore year, my high school cross country coach, he kind of convinced me. He was like, oh man, you'll be good in that 400. And then he was like, you got to run cross country to run that 400, because I did the relay. And I did not want to run cross country. Yeah. And he motivated me and he kind of pushed me through it. And then it just went from there.
Wow. Amazing. Well, it looks like you men have had an amazing season so far. I know the big goal, Nationals, that's still out there. Christian, we know that you won the South Florida Invitational. We talked about that. Let's take a look at some of the results for you guys from this season. We'll run them down, starting with the Border Clash. You finished third out of nine. Embry-Riddle Invitational, that was fourth out of 15. In the St. Leo Invitational, fifth place out of 14 teams. And then the Florida State Invitational, you were 11th out of 30 teams. And, of course, the USF Invitational as a team, fourth out of 17. And you, of course, were the winner. That was some outstanding stuff. And we appreciate the men's cross-country team joining us. Well, that's all the time that we have. We want to thank all of our guests, Coach Judy Wilson, and the Lady Falcon runners, Sophia Azzolini and Giovanna Mead. It was also great to have Christian Rocco and Mitchell Curtis from the men's cross country team with us on this episode as well. That's all for the Fan Show. I'm Tom James. Thank you for tuning in, and we will see you next time on the Falcon Athletic Network.